About 4 million years ago, I wasn't around then, our ape-like ancestors left the safety of their trees and took the first step toward humanity. They started carrying food over long distances and using tools to prepare it. But what if they hadn't? What would our world look like if we still walked on all fours? Detective Morales wakes up on a soft mattress in his room with very low ceilings. His legs and arms are roughly the same length, which makes moving on all fours much more convenient and faster. Back pain from standing, walking, or sitting upright all day isn't such a problem in this world. But that doesn't mean Morales isn't exhausted. He heads to the kitchen with low, wide furniture. The fridge has pull-out drawers that go the whole length of the wall. Morales grabs a small packet of milk and pops in a straw. He's about to take a drink when suddenly the phone rings. It's built right into the wall and wired as part of his smart house. The screen shows that it's the sergeant calling. Yeah, boss.
Yeah, we got another missing IPAC. We need to close this case today, or I'm taking you off it.
Sounds like it's going to be another great day on the job, Morales thinks sarcastically. I'm on my way. He ends the call and grabs a quick shower. Of course, the cabin is low to the floor. There's a built-in sitting space so that the user's hands are free, a common theme for all amenities in this world. Morales pulls a long shelf from a low wardrobe in his bedroom. His jumpsuit is easy to step into and fasten closed. The detective then puts on his IPAC. If he hears the word one more time, he's gonna lose it. The IPAC is a smooth, thin box. It automatically clings to the user's back, and a message lights up, brain neurons connected, when the wired electrodes stick to the nape of the neck. Since, in this reality, a person's hands are used for walking and standing, the IPAC has robotic arms that extend and move seamlessly thanks to that neural connection. Morales puts on his shoes, all four of them, although his flexible glove sneakers go on his hands, of course. As he leaves the apartment, he looks into the retina scanner that locks the door. You might be wondering how society has advanced so far, if people rarely use their hands for anything. Well, because humans get around on all fours, more blood enters their brains, and this affects the intellect. The brain might not have developed bigger, but it is more efficient. In a world that needs hand-free tools and conveniences, technology has advanced to meet those demands. In the city where our hero lives, low, wide buildings line the streets. Advertisements and posters are pasted directly on the pavement for the eyes to see comfortably. Among them, Morales notices an ad for a traveling circus. Today's the premiere, don't miss it! The detective smiles. His life seems like a circus with what's been happening lately. Vehicles lie low to the ground like bobsleds on wheels. The driver lies down on the horizontal seat and rides leaning forward. But Morales decides to take the snake-like bus today. He sees people chatting, watching videos, and reading e-books on the screens extending from their IPACs. Two teens discuss the blockbuster they recently saw at the movies. Yes, cinemas are quite different as well. A huge screen is mounted on the ceiling, and people lie on their backs on soft sofas and watch movies like The Starry Sky. Apparently, these kids saw a new horror flick. It was about scary people who can walk on two legs. Finally, our hero arrives at the beach, where someone has stolen a citizen's IPAC.
What am I supposed to do now? Who would do such a thing?
The woman cries. This is not the first case like this. Over the past month, IPACs have been stolen from people all over the city. The police can't do anything. No witnesses, no cameras, no fingerprints or traces. However, this time, Morales manages to find some very strange footprints in the sand. That's exactly the problem. There was a line of footprints, but no handprints. How was the culprit getting around without arms? Were they walking upright on their legs? Why would anyone do that? The detective scans the print with his IPAC and finds that sneakers with such a sole pattern are used at a local gym nearby. Morales follows the trail. In the gym, people jog on wide treadmills. They lie on bicycles with four pedals, one for each limb. You won't find any elliptical machines here. What's the point when there are no stairs in buildings? Morales sees two wrestlers grabbing a drink of water at the low fountain near the changing rooms. A nostalgic smile momentarily lights up his face. All the gym-goers are walking around in the same sneakers that left the footprints on the beach. Who could this possibly be? Morales wonders to himself as he scans the room. Everybody's walking on all fours. Nobody seems to be hiding anything. It looks like the case has led him to a dead end, but that's when he sees a young woman coming out of the yoga room. She flashes him a smile, and Morales grins back. The woman approaches him and introduces herself as Alice. She asks if it's his first time here, what with a puzzled look on his face. Morales considers questioning her about any suspicious-looking gym-goers, but he decides to lay low for now. Plus, he'd be lying if he didn't admit that he was a little enamored by Alice. There was something about her, something charming but mysterious. To his surprise, she invites him to grab a cup of coffee at the cafe down the street. He agrees. In the cafe, instead of chairs and tables, pillows lie on the floor around large wooden coasters. Sure, you could use your eyeback arms to hold your coffee, but it's not very comfortable to lift your head to finish a drink. That's why straws have become the perfect solution. They grab their coffees and sit down at a secluded table in the corner. That's when Morales tells Alice about his investigation, and she admits that she'd recently seen an upright walking man in the circus. Morales immediately remembered the faded poster on his block. It was looking like this unusual case was finally coming to an end. Kind of a strange trend, isn't it? This idea of people walking on their hind legs we're seeing more and more in the movies and arts. Alice glazed at him from across the coaster table. I don't know, it's just entertainment. Morales' mind was now back on the case. I'm sorry, but I have to head back to work. Thank you for the lovely conversation, Alice. He's looking at you, kid. Later that evening, with the fresh tip in his brain, the detective heads out of his apartment. He walks to the circus on streets lined with low lights built right into the sidewalk. When he gets there, the performance is in full swing. People have settled around the stage. Seats have no legs, and instead of backs for, well, your back, they have front ones for the chest. Up on the stage, though it's not very high, two upright walking twin brothers act as miracle people. They've just become the main suspects in this case. Morales decides to investigate the premises. He eventually finds a secret room located under the stage. Inside is a mountain of all the missing eyebacks. Well, 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 look who we have here. It was Alice, and she was standing upright. She was with the twins, and she ordered them to grab Morales. The detective realized that he'd walked right into a trap. In an instant, his eyeback whipped out his badge. You are all under arrest. Don't move. That didn't stop the brothers. They grabbed him on either side. It turns out this was all Alice's doing. Her brothers were just pawns in her scheme. Why did you leave me here? Did you want to get caught? Morales implored. I wanted you to understand, she explains. This species has evolved the wrong way. We're supposed to walk upright. But those eyebacks made us lazy and helpless. We need to work more with our own hands. We'll eventually grow tall and graceful. We will rise. You're insane, it was all Morales could say. You'll see for yourself, detective. Boys, get his eye back. Alice clearly didn't know what she was getting herself into. Morales was a former wrestling champion, and law enforcement eyebacks come with their own special gizmos. He overcame the brothers while his eyeback whipped out the cuffs in the blink of an eye. Morales booked all three of them. Case closed. But how would you imagine a world where humans walked on all fours? Let me know down in the comments. If you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right, and remember, stay on the bright side of life.